In episode 8 of Televised Carnage, Team Rutherford takes on Team Miyazaki. Rutherford has brought two new builds to the show this week, starting with El Toro. This car is offensively equipped with two front-mounted miniguns, and I've talked about this on a previous build video, but the Deadeye perk is going to allow him to hit on three pluses most of the time, helping to activate Televised Carnage and generating audience votes. Equipped exactly like El Toro, El Gato is going to help to locate, close with, and destroy his enemies. Up next is the Daring Drifters from Tokyo, Team Miyazaki, led by new addition to the show, the Green Knight. This performance car is offensively equipped with a heavy machine gun, but its real power lies in its perks, power slide, restraint, and expertise. With a max gear of 6 and a handling of 5, this car is going to drive circles around its opponents. Backing it up is the first of two buggies, Midnight. This buggy is equipped with front-mounted rockets, bringing much-needed firepower to this team, and all in an 11-can package. It only has 6 hull points, so it is a bit of a glass cannon, but if it breaks away, it's a decent racer on its own. As a copy of Midnight, Blackjack helps round out the team. Can these crazy Miyazaki drifters take on the militaristic might of Team Rutherford? With the team builds out of the way, it's time to move on to the main event, Death Race, Confusion Mode. With the successful launch of their Kickstarter for the French edition of the Gaslands rulebook, Astrolabe Interactive has reached a stretch goal allowing them to produce the Overdrive magazine. In the first edition, they presented several optional rules for the Death Race scenario. The one we're going to use is Confusion Mode. In these optional rules, both teams move in opposite directions of each other. For instance, Team Miyazaki is going to move in gates 1, 2, and 3, and then Rutherford will move in gates 3, 2, 1, both racing to the finish. First one across wins. With both teams deployed, it's time to begin with turn 1, gear phase 1, and all vehicles selecting their first activation. Without anything happening, we move on to turn 1, gear phase 2, and both teams closing in on that first gate, before moving on to turn 1, gear phase 3. This is where the action's gonna pick up as vehicles unlock their weapons. El Gato unleashes a rain of fire on Midnight, dealing 5 hull points of damage. As Blackjack advances, he targets his teammate with a tailgate smash attack, which triggers the performance car's special rule slip away. This performance car's special rule states that whenever it's targeted by a tailgate or T-bone smash attack and declares an evade itself, it immediately receives a free activation. And this can also be triggered by friendly vehicles. Blackjack will continue the action in turn 1 gear phase 4, utilizing his handguns on El Toro and dealing him 1 hull point of damage, before El Toro smashes into the front of Midnight and taking 1 hull point of damage himself and dealing a lethal amount to the Miyazaki buggy. As Midnight becomes a smoking hulk on the battlefield, its rockets ignite, causing it to explode, dealing damage to all vehicles within range, 1 to El Toro, 2 to El Gato, and 3 to Blackjack. Finally, breaking away from the pack, the Green Knight is able to utilize its power slide ability to gain some much needed distance. In turn 1, gear phase 5, Team Miyazaki has the only active vehicles. As both can activate in gear 6, this game is over. The Green Knight leisurely strolls over the finish line, bringing victory to Team Miyazaki. Congratulations, Team Miyazaki, on your spectacular victory. You really pulled Rutherford's pants down and showed him that sometimes cars are faster than bullets, and made up for your humiliating defeat the last time you faced them in a death race. Well, that's gonna bring episode 8 of Televised Carnage to a close. Thank you for watching, and remember to like and subscribe for future episodes of Televised Carnage. If you're enjoying my content, remember that liking, commenting, and subscribing help a small channel like mine grow. Will you help me reach more Wastelanders?